amazing animals. In the last video, we have learned the concept of habitat. Now, what is actually the habitat? Habitat is nothing but a place where the living organisms live or the animals live. That is called as a habitat. Animals live in a different area. For example, in the forest, in the polar region, in the mountains, in the ocean, in the desert. Yes, we can find the different types of varieties of the animals in the different areas. But according to that, they have to build a body. Am I right? Build the body in the meaning does not mean they have to go for the gym. They have to develop the body according to the climate. So the next point today, in today's video, we are going to discuss the adaptation in animal. Now, what is actually the adaptation? Means, now see, according to the different climate, means now if you will, we have the different habitat. Where a different habitat we have learned, that is the animals are found in the forest, in the polar region, in the ocean. Am I right? So according to that, they have to develop their body. They have to develop their body. Means according to the habitat, they have to adapt themselves, adapt to develop their body, their feeding habits. For whatever they are going to eat, they have to develop their according to the habitat. So like that, they have, as they want to develop their body according to the habitat, they have adapted a different in the body structure. They have developed in the, some animals have developed in the body structure, in the feeding, food feeding habits. Are you getting this? In short, we can say according to the habitat, the animals have to develop their body. They have to develop their body in the food feeding habit. In the, we can see the organism have to breathing organ. They have to develop the breathing organ. They have to adapt according to the habitat. Are you getting this? So some animals have developed their body structure in a form of scales. Now we have learned the animals which lives in the water. What they are called? Do you remember? I have taught you the one word. What they are called? The animals which lives in the water. What they are called? Yes, they are called as an aquatic animal. They are called as an aquatic animals. Now see, the animals which are living in the water. How is the body? Can you just imagine one of the animal? Mostly we can imagine the fish. Yes, how is the body structure of the fish? It is a streamlined, am I right? It is a streamlined body, am I right? So, and it has a scales. It has a scale, not your scale, which you are, the not your ruler, which you are using for drawing a line, that not scale. See, these are the scales which can be seen on the fishes, am I right? Why they have their scales on the body? To remove the water from their body. They remove the water from the body. Are you getting? Even the reptiles, they have the scales on the body. You might have seen the snake. They also have scales on the body. They have the scales on the body. Are you getting? According to the habitat means the place where the organism live. According to that, they have to adapt themselves. They have to develop their body structure. Are you getting? So the animals which lives in the water, they have scales on the body. Even the reptiles, they have scales on the body. Are you getting? The next body structure, shell. Now, have you seen the tortoise? Turtle, yes, they have a hard covering. They have a hard covering on their body. Am I right? What is the use of that? When anything's on an enemy attack to the particular animals, they can protect themselves. They can hide their body under this hard covering. That is called as a shell. They can cover their body. They can cover their body with under this hard covering that is called as a shell to protect from the enemy or any danger. In any danger to keep away from the to keep the body away from the danger, they hide under the this hard covering which is called as a shell. It is found in the most of the animals such as snail, tortoise, turtle. They found the we can see the shell, that is a hard covering on the body. Then the next, you might have seen the birds. Yes, now what? In the class 3rd, we have learned the bird lesson, whole bird lesson. Am I right? Do you remember that bird lesson? In that, the birds have feathers on their body. What is the use of the feathers? It is used to fly. It helps them to fly. Am I right? It helps them to fly, and also it protect them from the hot sun and cold winds and rain. It protect them from the hot sun, cold winds and rain. The feathers are useful for the birds to keep their body warm. Are you getting this? Then you can see the some animals, those who are living in the polar region. The animals which are living in the polar region, they have a very thick fur on their body. In the last video only I have told you why they have fur on their body. Yes, why do they have the fur on their body? To protect it from the severe cold. Am I right? To protect it from the cold. They have a thick fur on their body. Or for example, if you can take a sheep, sheep has the thick fur that we call as a wool. Are you getting this? Now there is one concept which is given as a camouflage. Now what is actually the animal, what is the meaning of camouflage? Now see, there are some animals. Now for example, if you will take tiger, lion, where do they live? Live in the forest. Where do they live? They live in the forest. Now, if you might have seen the forest, which forest whether they live? They live in little bit where the grass is little bit yellowish. Yes or no? Now, some animals like tiger, zebra, grasshopper, they have can wash their body. Can wash their body with the habitat, means the habitat, the place where they can they are living, means most their body according to their surrounding, their surrounding to protect it from the enemies, so they are called as a camouflage animal. Some animals like chameleon can even change the color according to the surrounding. Why do they do so? Can you just tell me? Because to protect it from the hunting, to prevent themselves from the hunting. Are you getting? They merge their body in their surrounding so that if the any hunter will come to prey them or the to hunt them. Any hunter, if they hunt them to protect them from this hunting, they merge their body in the surrounding. Are you getting? So such a feature is called as a camouflage. And protect their body according to the surrounding. They are called as a camouflage animal. Are you getting this? So I hope you have understood what is meant by the adaptation. And adaptation is developed by the animals such as in a body structure such as scale, shell, feathers, fur or wool. Are you getting this? I hope you have understood it. So today's work is that you have to read the whole lesson twice and remove the difficult words till the point which I have taught you. You getting this? Thank you.